Miss Wendy, please. Hi, good afternoon. I hope that after a heavy lunch, you are not so sleepy. Okay, and hopefully that this session, I mean, all of you already have some knowledge, you know, living with elderly. By the way, anybody stay with any elderly? Okay, very good. okay. Okay, so I hope that today you will glean something out of this session. And of course, if you are interested, there are books available online. You know, you can tap on the resources. So without much further ado, I shall proceed. So every one of us will live with the aged one day. Even ourselves, we are aging also. So this talk is also preparing yourself for aging. Oh, must on. Yeah. Okay, sorry. So today, this is actually my outline. I will tell you about what are the tips in caring for elderly. And it is very important to have a safe environment. How do you communicate with an elderly person? And then I will talk also about the fluid intake, how to promote an active lifestyle, medication, personal care, and sleep. And what are the tips in caring for elderly? Okay, before I go on to this, currently there is about 250,000 of elderly above 65 years old, okay, in Singapore. And in the year of 2030, the number will rise. Do you know how many elderly there will be by that time? Just make a guess. Yes, correct. It's about 900,000. So everywhere you go, you will see a lot of elderly. In fact, I will be in one of the cohort also. So none of us can escape aging, all right? So better, you know, not to be sorry, but then it's good to actually learn much more about elderly. And then currently, if you look at the newspaper, there's a lot of articles, you know, actually it's about aging also. They talk about fall, dementia, you know, it's really an in thing. And then in Singapore, our government has done a lot for our elderly. Maybe you want to leave some example. What has the government done for all the elderly in Singapore? Programs, activity, anybody just throw out? Not much. Okay, very good. PG card, yes, pioneer generation. Any more things? Yes, but it still really helps though in the outpatient side. Again? Yes, correct, CPF life, because that is for the catastrophic illnesses, okay? That is MediShield life. Yeah, very good. Any more thing? There's a lot. Yeah, correct. The HPB board is another organization. They have done a lot about healthy eating, how to keep your mind cognitively active. Any more?
Certain groups are eligible for this. If the income is above certain.
Yes, correct. They do have a mean testing. Yeah, they do have. Yeah, thanks for telling. Okay, maybe I'll just tell you some of the things, because I don't want just my talk just to be on this scope, because caring for aging is actually a very wide topic, and there's a lot of books, internet, all talking about aging. Okay, actually the field of studying aging in the big term is called gerontology. Okay, this is a very huge field, which a lot of people are really very interested. So the government has done a lot in the CHAS card, but there's a mean testing. Okay, there's a limit like 1,004 and 1,008, then you're applicable. Like for me, my mom, she's not eligible. Okay, and then there's also the BCA. The government has done a lot for the elderly-friendly environment. When you look around, especially if you go to some of the area like Bukit Merah, the other side, they have elderly-friendly, you know, from the bus stop to the HDB. And then currently, the government has done all the lift. Every floor, there's actually a lift. And then the government is going to also revamp some of the lift because there are incidents that happen. And of course, they also give every year, right, a certain amount of money to the elderly. And then some of the elderly that are, for example, they have ADL dependent, they also have the, okay, like disability scheme, and then for the maid caregiver, and then they also have maid waiver. Okay, that means instead of paying $120, if you employ a maid, right, they only charge you $60. So there's a lot of things that the government has done. And then even for like active aging, you know, under the People Association also, and the Council of the Third Age. I think some of you, I don't know whether you heard about that. You can Google, very good also. They even have a program whereby they want to keep the elderly active with their mind. They actually, you can collect the kit from actually Bishan. So there's a lot of things they have done. Okay, and then also the budget also, they also look into, they also give money, you know, to promote healthy and successful aging. Okay, so I shall go on. Sorry that I sidetracked on and off a little bit, but I thought it's good to actually go into that. So we know that helping an elderly is always not very clear-cut. Okay, when you see a doctor, because everyone is different. I cannot say that step one, this one will work for you. You know, step two, this will work for you, because every one of us is different. If you look at your finger, it's all different. Okay, every one of us is born very different, different genetic background, culture, you know. So we actually have to tailor, you know, to different needs. And especially the most challenging part in elderly care is what, you know, when you care for elderly that has dementia. This is the most challenging part, because especially when they have a lot of behavioral problems, many times it is not the patient that suffer, no, it's the caregiver, because they undergo a lot of stress, you know, mentally, socially, financially also, because you need money to also take care of the elderly. Okay, so like I already mentioned, all of us are very unique in our genetic. None of us is the same. Okay, and then when you take care of elderly, it's good to do some homework also. Okay, when you see a doctor, when you bring your mother or father to see the doctor, or you know, it is good to know the background, like what medication she's on, what kind of illnesses she has, because sometimes the doctor can ask you quite a lot of things. So if you don't prepare your homework, happen when you go there, let me abs my sister or my brother. So it's actually good to do a bit of homework. Because right now, elderly, once they are above 6 medication, it's quite a lot of medication, all right? And then it is good to compile a personal information about the elderly also, because sometimes some of them, they may have frequent fall. Okay, sometimes the doctor can ask, you know, so what happened in the past, how did they fall, you know, they will ask you when, how, and what happened after that. So there's a lot of things that you need to do, but don't be stressed by it. Currently, instead of writing paper, I know some of you are so techni-savvy. Now there's a course, you know, in SIM called what, you know, technology in gerontology. That means what, you know, everything is technical, no. Now you go to the school, no more, they always give you paper, no. They want you everything online. And then because it is shown that technology do actually help, you know, in the elderly also. Like in Japan, because it's a very fast aging population, what happened is that they even use technology, you know, such as like they have pet therapy, whereby they have a robot pet, you know, maybe the elderly, you know, have dementia, they actually have this pet therapy, you know. It's actually a robot lah. Then the robot dog can bark, you know. Oh, you can, you know, they can do a lot of funny things. And then they do a lot of things on technology lah, very fantastic. So sometimes you can even YouTube, you know, they even have in some of the daycare center, they even have this sumo fighter, you know. I don't know what they call it lah, but they use that to, in the daycare, make it very interesting, you know. It's like a game also. Okay, so there are many things that really actually went above my brain also. Sometimes you cannot just catch up. And then at the moment, you know, one tap, everybody has a computer at home or a tab or even your handphone. Very good. You know, sometimes you can do a Google or YouTube, but be careful. Make sure that it's scientific and reliable. So don't believe everything that they say. Okay, always check. If you're not sure, always consult the doctors or the healthcare professionals. Okay. So what are the tips in caring for elderly? To be honest with you, because for me, I'm working in the geriatric center. I'm a nurse clinician, and every day I do geriatric assessment. Geriatric means elderly above 65 years old. So what we do is that they will come to me and I will ask, usually I'll tell some of my colleagues, I will do an assessment from head to toe, simple language. That means I will ask them, you know, about their eating habit, their daily lifestyle, ADL activities. There are 6 components. I will ask them about the IADL, that means instrumental activities of daily, for example, taking baths, etc. I'll ask them about the sleeping pattern, behavior, looking at their medical. It's a whole chunk of things, you know. But then research already shown that it has proven to really help the elderly, because from there we will compile a nursing care plan together with the doctors, and then we try to help the caregiver. So that is the setting that I'm working. But I realized that as the years goes by, this has been coming to my 8 years working there. I find that looking after this group of elderly is very challenging and very interesting. And there is really no cure for dementia, because dementia is also on the rise, you know. Okay, it's on the rise. And remember, dementia is not an aging process, okay? It is actually a disease. It can be caused by Alzheimer's dementia. It can cause by stroke, Lewy body. Actually, none of us know what is the causes. Or it can be caused by Parkinson's disease, you know, there are many causes.
Drug-induced
causes, not many. Yeah. So currently, there's really no cure for dementia. Doesn't mean you, even if the tablet that they pop in, is just to delay the processes. But in the long run, they will still deteriorate. And another non-pharmacological approach is actually activities, exercise. Okay, this is actually the in thing. Because once... Okay, but there's still not so much of the RCT. What is RCT? Randomized controlled trial yet. So because if it's proven, then the doctor will give everybody coconut oil to drink. Okay, but so far that isn't proven yet, lah. Correct. Yeah, that day I read it. The coconut oil with extra virgin. They say if you take that, do help you lah with the cognition. But you see, sometimes doesn't mean that if one thing is good, you every day take. You know, because you know healthy lifestyle is composed of everything. That means you have to keep your mind very active, exercise, and then socialization, engagement, and then you have to know how to actually handle your own stress. Okay, so there are many components. So till today, nobody know actually what is the causes of dementia. Okay, so very important thing, I must say that the basic principle is actually patience and respect. Okay, very important thing, because sometimes what I observe is that some of them, when they have dementia, they have a lot of behavioral problems. And then it's really not easy to tackle, no, but just tell you some of the story. I have one nursing colleague. Her mother-in-law actually got dementia, no, and she always will score a lot of vulgar words. She will always make a lot of noise. There was one day she told me, when she opened the door, suddenly she spit at her, So it was so demoralizing. And then she was taking some of the medicine. And then after that, she told me what, she said, Wendy, I just tell you, when they take the medicine, when I take out the medicine, she's better. So sometimes I can tell you honestly, there's really no straight cut, But I must say honestly, that doesn't mean that you don't take medicine, because it is still research proof that some of the medicine do slow down the processes, okay? If not, our geriatric clinic will close down. Okay, but still, this is still actually proven to slow down the processes, okay? And of course, we do have other principles. Okay, you have to be tolerant, you have to love the elderly, The filial piety actually do come in, very important. Okay, so definitely when a person ages, some decline in the mental and physical capability is inevitable. Because as a person get older, what happens? They are very slow in their response. Okay, not like before, they are so sharp, right? And then everything that they do can slow down, they are not as before. So sometimes in terms of like financial management, or maybe recognizing a certain place, they do not know how to come back, after when they've gone to a certain place. So they are not like before. So very important thing, as a caregiver or yourself preparing for aging, very important to have a safe environment. There's a condition called in the elderly, it's called hoarding behavior. I don't know whether you saw some of the Straits Times recently. Quite some time back, I saw one was... Yeah, correct. This one is for elderly lah. But okay, what happened was that this patient, she was actually staying with her daughter. Her whole house is so cluttered until both of them have to sleep at the staircase, And then the social worker has to come in and clear all stuff. And then especially when you keep so many things, what will happen? The cockroach, the ants, all will come. So it's very important. But remember that even the social worker, when they come in, they cannot remove everything, because you know why? Certain things are very sentimental to the elderly. Because I ever heard of cases whereby if they remove, sometimes the bed are infested with bed bugs, When they remove it, what happened? The elderly, some of them died, Yeah, so they have to be very careful. I do not know what is the logic, but maybe because there's a sentimental value. Yeah, so we have to be very, very careful. Yeah. So, and then just another interesting, currently, our minister, Mr. Chan Chun Seng, I think, yeah, they are coming up with a Vulnerable Act. I do not know whether you all know, because currently, if there's an elderly abuse or the whole house is cluttered with things, they don't allow, the social worker or the doctors or the nurses to go in, They cannot just barge in, At the moment, the law in Singapore is you cannot barge in unless they open the gate. So in future, there will be another law coming out. It's called the Vulnerable Act. It's still not yet coming out, whereby if they suspect there's an elderly abuse or if the elderly harm themselves, you know, or even the this act will be pertaining to 18 and above, so they can go into the house and they can actually help the elderly. Okay. Anyway, elderly abuse is another whole chunk of story, which I will not touch on that, but there are seven kinds of elderly abuse. Very interesting. So, okay, so very important thing, we will, you know, help them to clear with their permission. And then I remember, okay, what happened to that case, like I told you, right? Finally, the social worker came in, and because the daughter herself, she also got some mental history also. Yeah, so the social worker went in and just to help them make sure that the place at least is livable. Okay, very important. So what about the things, I'm sure you already know, because sometimes environment, why a person fall down, okay? Usually it's because the environment is not safe. But there can be other factors also. Sometimes it's an internal factor, that means poor vision, okay? Or sometimes the elderly, when they stand up, their blood pressure drop, that one is called postural hypotension, they can also fall down. So there are many things why they fall down. Or maybe they have a stroke, you know, or heart attack, then they fall down. Okay, so there are many reasons. So usually this one will need a very thorough assessment. And in our geriatric clinic, we actually have a fall and balance clinic. So if the elderly always fall down, usually they will refer them to that department. Okay. So very important thing is anything that will cause, you know, the environment to be not safe, such as your slippery mat, like all this cloth, very slippery. Okay, when you step on it, the elderly can fall down also. So it's good to always remove it. Yeah, curb also, yeah, very important. So always replace with a non-slip mat. In fact, right now, Singapore very good. Like if you go NTUC or Cold Storage, they have this non-slip mat, very good. Yeah, so those that are not slippery, you can just put it on it. And then improper footwear is also one of the main cause for fall. Now I'm checking all your shoe. Because what happened is that even like for myself, no, sometimes when your shoe is not proper, what happened? Even yourself, you can fall down also. No. In fact, this year, I must say honestly, a lot of my friends, her mother, a lot of them fell down, you know, this year. I don't know why, a lot of them all hurt their leg. One of them went operation for the leg. Another one fell down. So fall actually in Singapore, age 65 and above, currently in Singapore, there are about 25 to 30% of the elderly do fall. And once they have a fall, what happened to them? What happened when a person falls? Yes, correct. Yeah. What happened is that when they fall, you know what happens? Some of them can have disability, you know. They will fall down. And then once they cannot walk, what will happen to them? Some of them have fractured neck or femur. Wow, very jialat, you know, fractured neck or femur. The bone, because a lot of women, you know, after when you're age 35 and above, your bone will go through osteoporosis. Even men do have also, you know. So osteoporosis is actually the bone become very hollow, no? So you are very susceptible to a fracture. That's why it's very important when you're age 35 and above, you need to take calcium tablet. But take too much calcium also not so good. You know what happened? Cause memory problem. So if you are frightened, you can ask the doctor to check your calcium level. So don't take when you're very, very old, no? Because during that time you take, it doesn't help so much. But of course, we will still take precaution. If they have a fall or they have a fracture, usually we will do a bone mineral density. Okay, for the woman, we will do that. And then if need be, some of them, they will really have to take calcium. Of course, under the sunlight, your body can also make vitamin D. But how many of you go under the sunlight? Correct, all of us are working. Like for me, I'm guilty. I'm always indoor. So I just pump myself with two vitamin calcium and vitamin D. It always work together. And then no need to buy those very expensive one. You know, some of the vitamins, the supplements are not cheap right now. If you buy, a lot of people pop in, you know, wow, so many tablets, you know. Actually, you can buy those good and cheap. I mean, I'm not promoting actually my pharmacy, but you can go downstairs, very cheap, 100 tablets. I think it's about $5 plus only. Okay, sorry. Yeah, I'm teaching you all to be save budget because you must save for your retirement. Yeah, because all the supplements not cheap, you know. Now you see a lot of company are promoting, you know, you must take this, take that, take this, take that. Then you ended up yourself with so many tablets. I think you eat more tablets than your rice. Correct? Yeah. So
actually morning sun 10 to 11 in the evening to be all right. You can go from 12 on very, very hot. You cannot bear it. Every human being must have sunlight.
But I'm guilty. I'm not, because I come to work very early. I reach here 7, I go back sometimes 8, 9, 10. So I don't really have the sunlight. Yeah. Okay, but anyway, if you don't have the other form, and then of course drinking milk, you know, tofu, but some of them don't like milk. Lor. Yeah, so, and then another form of those people who really has osteoporosis, they have 1-4. Sometimes, this is some of the knowledge, lah. Some of them may go for polio injection, or some of them may on Fosamax tablet. But when you take that, nah, don't lie down on the bed, nah, because they have reflex gastric also. So you need to, I think, wait 1 hour later. But this one usually ordered by the doctor, lah. You don't buy it on your own, okay? So remember, improper footwear is very slippery, especially the Japanese slipper. All these are not very good, okay? So we always encourage them to wear proper footwear, because once you have a fall, it's really no joke. Yeah, and then some of them, you know, happen when they fall down, some of them have intracranial hemorrhage. Then they got to go for surgery, you know, burr hole. I think it's very terrible to open up the brain. Actually, as a nurse myself, sometimes I also have phobia, you know, when I see a patient fall, or even some of my friends. So I remember long ago, one of my friends, you know, she's very young, like in her 40 plus. I don't know what happened in the shopping center. The guy was doing something, then she tripped on him, you know, and then fell down. And then she got a fracture, you know. So imagine that 40 plus also can have fracture. Yeah, so don't take lightly lah when there's a fall. So remember that when it's a raining day or what, just be more extra careful. The best, don't go out lah. And then if you are not very good your mobility, please have a walking aid now. Okay? I mean for those elderly lah, if they need to, but if it's raining very heavily, the best thing, don't go out lah, because it's very dangerous. Okay? Even for driving also lah. And like I mentioned, but not everybody wear this kind of shoe, okay? I know it's a bit old fashioned, but this is more for elderly. Of course, track shoe is one of the best. Okay, track shoe, like I see some of you wear, are very comfortable, very good. And then remember that, make sure that the sole over here, like this one is quite, we recommend for those female elderly patients, not for guys. So this one you can buy from the shop, it's very cheap. This one is made in Taiwan, it's about $10 or $12. Yeah, very cheap. Yeah, it's quite, you can buy it from a lot of places like Ang Mo Kio, Toa Payoh, there's a lot of places they sell. Make sure that is the sole are non-resistant, okay? And then always buy shoe in the evening. Why? The answer is there, lah. Because usually nighttime our feet will swell. Okay, so don't buy in the morning, if not, your feet cannot go in. Of course, you can buy other types, lah. If you have money, some of them buy Pexi, lah, the high, very nice one. Okay. So next, I will go into the communication. Okay, so very important thing, communication always also has a safe environment. Especially when you communicate with elderly, what happens is that sometimes they got hearing problem. Always when you talk to them, it is always good to face them. Because some of the elderly, they cannot hear very well. They tend to read your lips also. Yeah, because sometimes what happens is that if the elderly is in the bedroom and then the son or the daughter is in the living room, sometimes if you communicate, they don't know what you're talking about. And then if you do not communicate properly, what will happen? Misunderstanding. Okay? And then always always face the elderly and then talk very slowly. Don't rush. And then always use simple language. Okay, simplicity is the most important thing. And then sometimes if the elderly, they cannot see very well or they cannot hear very well, it's very good to always use pictures or visual model to explain your concept, especially when pertaining to financial or buying house. Because elderly at this stage, right, they are quite well-to-do also. Some of them may have properties and whatever. Yeah, so it's always good to sit down, discuss with your dad or mom or your grandmother or etc. Okay? And always don't be in the rush. If you don't have the time, then maybe you can tell the elderly, I'll talk to you some other time. Because if you're in the rush, you tend to be very hasty. And then the elderly, they know your visual cue one. Eh? Wow, my daughter, my son are like so rushing, are not interested in me, like that, you know. Yeah, so very important thing, always have some time with them. And then very important thing also when you communicate with them, if you don't mind, sometimes you can even like hold them, you know, okay, talk to them. Then,
human touch.
Yeah, human touch, very important. Okay, so very important. And then, like for example, when I do a geriatric assessment, there's one component about depression. Imagine sometimes if I ask them, are you depressed? Or another one.
Simple.
Yeah, it's different, right? Yeah. So sometimes very important, you know, like when I ask them, you know, I have to be very sensitive also. Because if I ask just on the first one, don't get simple, you know, it's like you're not interested, you know, just doing the job. That's why for me, I always go the second one, I'll just hold them. I know it's very sensitive. Because
1 month. After that, I was alone, you know. So what happened was that I was very frightened, and because you're so new, and then actually I went to polyclinic to work about 6 years. Now then I came back to my geriatric, but I forgot, you know. See, even for my age, after I was around 30, in my 30 plus, coming to 40s already, and then I really lost touch there. So I had to relearn, you know. And then there's a lot of things that I learned from my doctors, and then the part I went overseas, like, and then I read up a lot. So another way
my voice loud. Okay, another way of learning is also reading also, because reading is very important, because not everybody will hold you by the hand and teach you everything, you know. So from that I learned, you know, and then I was very happy when I went to the US, like, I got hold of this book called Geriatric Assessment. And I went to John Hopkins actually for training. So from there, I read up a lot, and I was very thankful, you know, because they teach us, you know, actually how to ask about suicide. Very simple, you just ask them, you know, do you feel like harming yourself? Okay, that is the way to ask, lah, but you never ask them, look, your eyes. Actually, the relative will say, actually, my mother, was your eyes see, like, now you say this, they want to, yeah. So sometimes we have to be very sensitive, lah, okay, the way we ask.
You can say, do you want to go to heaven?
Oh, okay, yeah. But most of them will want, correct. Okay. Yeah, most of them will want, I mean, everyone want to go heaven, right? Who, yeah. Okay, so I thought this is something which is quite funny. So, of course, some of my patients, the most challenging one is those that, I remember there was another patient, you know, that came to me, the relative didn't come, he came in. So what happened was that, actually, I thought he had a heart attack, you know. What happened, he wear so tight, the ape, you know, wear so tight until he cannot breathe. So we had to change into our hospital clothing, and then because he came alone, so no choice, you know, I pushed the whole bed, you know, at my room there. First time I pushed a patient inside my room, like, with a bed. So I got to interview him, you know, and then he's very hard of hearing, and then the way he talk also not clear. So sometimes it's very challenging, like, you know, I got to literally go to his ear and talk to him, you know. So usually, you know, they will know, like, whether you are caring or not caring. Those kind, sometimes no relative as nurses, to be honest with you, nurses, doctor can ching chai bo chai one, right? I mean, I just say that, lah. No relative, ma, I can do anything to you. But for me, because I know God is watching me, lah, so I know that. So what I did was that, you know, I just do my best, lah. And I was so touched, you know, when that day, you know, because the wife do give him $10, lah, then he want to take lunch. So anyway, he got money, right? So I said, okay, lah, then use his money, lah. So I went to buy lunch for him, then after that, he need to be admitted, lah. So he was so grateful, you know. There was something that he said really touched me, make my day, you know. He shake my hand, he said, "Kam sia ho, tua mi si." Oh, I tell you, I was like, I mean, I don't expect people call me tua mi si, lah, but I tell you, I was so, it really makes my day, lah. So these are something that as a nurse, sometimes you do come across patients that are so grateful, you know, because he was also quite ill-treated by the adopted son, lah. So I really feel for him, but he's coming back to see us again. But I still remember, so communication is not so straightforward, you know, really. And very important thing is sometimes, especially when you tell the elderly, right, they forget. And then sometimes they also got hallucination. You tell them one thing, they interpret another thing, you know. So sometimes it's very challenging when the elderly, they have all these problems. So what to do? Sometimes you just have to hug them and then just tell them that, you know, you love him. Sometimes they will say, you don't care about me, you know, always come back so late. And like my mother got dementia. So sometimes she will say, you always come back so late. Is it you go and find boyfriend? I said, mommy, where got I find boyfriend? I so busy in the clinic because I got a lot of paperwork, you see. And yeah, so sometimes I just hug her, you know. You just have to, you know, this is also communication. So communication, remember, is not just verbal, no, it's your non-verbal cue also. I thought I'll just share with you all the practical aspect, lah, which is quite useful also. And then, oh dear. So, okay, remember if the elderly has a hearing aid, it's good to always let them wear a hearing aid. Lah. And then make sure that it's turned on also, lah, because sometimes it's not turned on, then you don't know whether they understand or not. Okay. And then also remember, female, remember, we all always speak very high-pitched tone. They cannot hear one, you know. So always remember, you cannot be so high speech, and then don't yell or exaggerate. Okay, always talk slowly, and then always use short sentences. And then sometimes it's good, you know, if the elderly, let's say, if they cannot really listen, you know, you can even write down also in English or Mandarin. You know, you can even write down in a piece of big paper or a board. And then remember, you know, when you talk to them, don't munch and chew, you know, eat Okay, sometimes we tend to do that. Then, like sometimes my mother during meal time, she like to eat and then talk, eat, talk. Then she cough, you know, choke with food. I always tell mommy slowly. I can tell my mother talk a lot. Sometimes, I don't know where she get the energy from. My mother is already about 89 years old. She really can out-talk you. So sometimes I just listen because after work, I so tired already. Go whole day talking until I got no strength. So I will just listen. That's why God gave us 2 years. Okay, to listen. Yeah. Okay, that's another sidetrack. Do you know that when the elderly, when they die, do you know which part is the last senses to go off? Yeah. Yes, correct. That's why when you talk to them, they know one. Yeah, so very important. I think it's very amazing. God give us this hearing. Very, very amazing. So as you talk to them, sometimes some of them may be in coma or they may be drowsy. They still can hear. No, yeah, you'd be very surprised. Okay, so always don't assume that the elderly don't know anything. You know, you everything make decision for them. Okay, don't do that because they may have their opinion or certain. Sometimes they may have things to tell you regarding about their money, their property or whatever lah. Okay, and then always provide time for the elderly to express themselves. Okay, don't assume that, I'm the daughter or I'm the, So always ask them, mom, what do you want, Or dad, what do you want for breakfast, for lunch, where you want to go? Sometimes you'll be very surprised, even simple things that they like to eat, like my mother like to eat chok, porridge. So sometimes I will travel, down to Toa Payoh because they got very lorong 8 down there, they got very nice porridge. Yeah, so make their life happy. So simple things in life, they feel very happy. And then sometimes if there's anything that they are not sure, you can clarify with them also. Okay. So just to show you some of the types of hearing aid. So this one, usually we don't buy off the counter like that. You need to see a ear, nose, throat specialist. But always remember that before the doctor prescribe this, always we have to check for impacted earwax. Because what happens is that elderly as they age, sometimes they cannot hear is because there's a lot of earwax in that ear. So normally what the doctor will do, they will do an otoscope and then they will remove all the earwax. Sometimes they may just give olive oil. Okay, they will soften the earwax, then they will remove it. In polyclinic, sometimes they will do an ear stringing. But this one is done by the doctors also. And then if really they still cannot hear, then they will see a ENT specialist. Okay, and then they will see also an audiologist whereby they will check again to see whether which type of hearing aid is suitable. Okay, and then just to let you know, hearing aid is not cheap, It costs into thousands of dollars. Okay, not cheap also. And sometimes some of them, when they're on hearing aid, they find that it's not very good. They may just use a pocket talker. This one is available in our clinic. Whereby it's something like an amplifier, whereby they will just put the earphone over their ears. And then we will just talk to them, over the microphone. Okay, this one is actually magnify the sound, and it's very loud, And then there's another one which I didn't put up. Maybe you can just take a look. Okay, I'm not introducing the company, but just to let you know that there are different kinds of, to amplify the sound. There's another company, what is this name? Mary Healthcare. Actually, it's another kind of hearing apparatus. You can take a look. Okay, whereby this one is much more high-tech, whereby they just put the earphone and then they just clip the magnifier over here. And then they come in different versions. Of course, some of them do have sound disturbance. That one is the cheaper kind. And then those more expensive ones is about 500 plus, can be very expensive.
Is it invisible for all elderly to become, part of hearing?
Okay, so far, from what I saw, the elderly population, not many. Usually, it's about 1, 2, 3%, not many.
It's not a normal type of thing.
Yeah.
We can have elderly who don't even have any problems.
Yes, correct. We do have, yeah. Because some of the elderly, you'll be very surprised, some are very good. They don't have health problems even when they reach 90, Yeah. Yes, some of them they don't have. So not everybody has. Well, some of my patients, what happened is that they try the hearing aid, then they say it make a lot of noise. So some of them, they replace with pocket talker. They do. Yeah, minority, yes. Correct. Because sometimes I see some of the caregiver, they shout, wow, they really shout with the elderly. And then in my room, they all shout here, shout there, until I also got giddiness. Yeah, so what I do is that normally I will take a pocket talker, and then I will adjust to the volume. And so far, I find that it really works. Yeah, it's very good, no? Because I have to do an appropriated mental test, okay, whereby I have to make sure, check whether they got dementia. So I find that this is very helpful. So far, I tried the Mary. It's not the best, but you have to really try it, no? Because every one of us is different. So I, this one very close, because it's just a microphone, very easy. And some of my caregivers, they like it so much. Yeah, so usually it costs about 200 plus only. So it's much more cheaper than your hearing aid, no? But there again, we want them to have a proper assessment to go to see the ENT specialist, you know, check, make sure no earwax, because we still go through the proper procedure. But some of them, if they already tried all the hearing aid, it doesn't work, then we will introduce them the pocket talker. Okay. But this is the latest one, the one that I show you, the Murray. Yeah, it's one of the latest. And it's quite effective because we try on. Even one of them, you go to the other room when they talk, they can hear. No? Yeah, so it's quite good also. Okay, next we will go in touch onto fluid intake. Very important. Elderly, sometimes it's what, you know, either they drink too much water or they don't drink at all. Yeah, some of the elderly, sometimes they only take 3 cups a day, you know, breakfast, lunch, dinner, that's all. It's not enough. You know why? Because our body consists of 70% of water. So you can drink some water now. 70% of water. And what happens is that when you don't drink enough water, what will happen? Because some of the elderly, when they lie down on the bed, if they don't drink enough, when they get up, the blood pressure will drop about 20 mercury. That is called postural hypotension. So they will become very dehydrated. Do you know some of my elderly, they admitted for dehydration, you know, because they don't eat enough, they don't drink enough. Yeah, so they will be admitted and then they will be on drip. That's why it's very important to always drink. At least I have to take 7 to 8 cups a day, unless they got heart problem. Okay, heart problem, normally they will reduce them, 1 liter to 1.5 liter if they got heart problem. Okay, because they don't want to overload the heart. But for you and me, we can drink more. Okay, okay. So, somebody showing me. And then another thing is make sure that they drink morning, afternoon, night time after 8. Please don't drink a lot of water. And we don't encourage them to drink Milo at 8 o'clock because Milo is also a stimulant, or coffee or tea. It's also a great stimulant. They will wake up very... Because if they wake up too often, what will happen to them? If they keep waking up in the middle of the night, what happened to them? Yes, because some of them, they want to save electricity. No, they don't on the light. Then they walk to the toilet, then pah, they fell down. Yeah, very common. So if they pass urine once or twice nocturnal in the night, it's okay. So encourage them, after it, don't drink a lot. Okay. And then next will be the active lifestyle. Because, okay, by the way, active lifestyle, this is also a medicine, you know, for active aging. Okay, always remember, doesn't mean you pop a tablet now, you solve everything. Always our patient come, nurse, doctor, just give me one tablet, solve all my problem. There's no such thing. Okay, because our body is very unique. Okay, doesn't mean, because the more medicine the elderly take, the more problems they will have, because medicine also got side effects. Okay, just to let you know, for example, some of the dementia drugs you take can cause a gastric diarrhea. Some of them can cause heart problem, you know. So doesn't mean all the medicine are good. And then some of the medicine for benign prostatic hypertrophy, BPH and large prostate, they take, they feel very giddy, they can fall down. Even Puriton, you all know about the Puriton tablet? When you got flu, you take the yellow kind tablet, Puriton. That one also a high fall risk, so we don't encourage elderly to take that. Even corn mixture also. Okay, so the best thing is... okay, maintain an active lifestyle, always have a good relationship and stay in touch with your loved ones. Okay, it can be your friends, your children, you know. And of course, there's also a lot of community centers now available with the SkillFuture Fund, right? Now they give about $500. Some of them can sign up for cooking class, baking. This is the best time to learn whatever that, like for me, I'm so busy, I got no time to go for all these classes. But actually, I would love to do some of the things, you know, like baking, sewing, etc. It's really nice. And then also singing also. Okay, so there are many other activities. I cannot list down everything. And of course, volunteering work is still, it's really an in thing right now in Singapore. So if you can, you can volunteer yourself in some of the palliative, you know, or even escort, you know, the elderly to see the doctor. And then even some of the daycare is very good for the elderly. But just to let you know, the daycare is not enough in Singapore. okay, our supply actually is very, the demand is very high, the supply is very low.
Yeah, the way they pay is they have some. Who want to work?
Yeah, correct. Actually, Singapore is really not enough. Correct, correct, yeah. Anyway, currently the waiting time for daycare is 6 months to 9 months. Like, it's very, and then a lot of daycare is located at the east zone. It's really not enough. Yeah, so even they are building more nursing home, it's really not enough. La. But like I say, we don't encourage elderly to go to nursing home unless there's no choice. So home is still the best place to actually age gracefully. Okay. So what are the active lifestyle they can involve? You know, walking is one of the best exercise. Of course, you need to walk to 10,000 steps, but not easy to reach. Because Health Promotion Board, now they have the watch, right? Need to walk 10,000 steps. I think I also don't meet. Okay, so it's good. Walking is very good. And then it also exercise or rehabilitation or walking, it enhance actually independence. And then especially when we exercise or walk, you know, your body will produce a hormone called endorphins. And they feel very, very happy. That's why it's good lah, to always exercise. Okay, it's still the good old therapy. And then it lifts up your spirit and improve your cognitive health. I hope I don't exceed the time. Okay, I shall go a bit faster. And then regular exercise is very important, at least 3 to 5 times a week. Okay, and then it also stimulates your cognitive stimulation. There's a lot of games available. Okay, maintain your social engagement. Okay, just to let you know, in this picture, this is my father. He passed away at the age of 98. Yeah, very good. He's cognitively very, very good, but he died of blood cancer. Yeah, so they actually want sample lah. So I have no choice, got to bring my dad to be one of them. So there's a lot of things that you can actually do, can maintain your perceptual and memory skill, you know. So you can do crossword puzzle, read newspaper, because there's television is not a very good activity, just to let you know. But I mean, it's still a social media, but it's still not a good activity. Then you can do knitting, jigsaw puzzle, sudoku, not easy lah, sudoku. Okay, there are many things you can do. And then how to actually help you, you know, sometimes if you know that you're forgetful or those people with mild dementia, they can actually have all this notepad, you know, or shopping list they can write down or stick on pack. Or sometimes cooking or some of them, they boil water, then they walk away, you know, they forgot. So you can even set a timer also. Yeah, but the best is to sit there and wait lah. Okay? And then you have a timer for taking medicine also. Some of them, because they are alone at home, so they can set timer. This one, some of them, they have to purchase online. Like, if you Google, they have. So they even can remind up to 4 times, you know, whereby they will remind them, it's a female voice, you know, please take your medicine, you know, or whatever. I don't know whether they have Mandarin or not. Okay, so they have many things. Okay, and then also, there are things that can help you. Is the pill box also very good? Because sometimes they can pack for 1 whole week. Then let's say if they didn't take right, the medicine is still there. Then you know that this, wow, my father, my mother got memory problems, so I better bring them to see a doctor. If they really got dementia, then you have to get somebody to supervise their medicine already. Okay, you can have a diary. Remember, having a handphone also doesn't really help much of our memory. You know. In fact, I think newspaper came out, you know, they say that a lot of things we rely on the tool, so which is not very good. Yeah, but we still need the phone because it's a form of communication. And then calendar also, very important. You can write down all the appointments. Sometimes, I mean, the hospital do send SMS, you know, all this reminder, but it's still good to write down. And then notice board also, wall calendar. There are many things, even the keys also, simple things. Always try to put in the same place. Because some of them go to the letterbox, you know, they leave it there, then they went home. So the thief or whoever will take the key. So always remember to lock your door. Can be quite stressful, you know, because sometimes when you're busy like myself, I ever left the key, you know, in the letterbox. So, wow, I tell you, really panic. Okay, so you have to really always put in the same place. Always check, like, even your car key or whatever, you know. Okay, very important. So always keep a list of the important numbers. Like, you know, like your father, mother, they need to remind her or whatever. Okay, sorry, I got to go fast. Okay, so the medication, very important. Know what your father, mother, or your, you know, they are taking. And then write down, it's good to write down a whole list, or you can key into your iPad, tablet, or whatever. When they see a doctor, the doctor will ask you what medicine they are on, you know. And then beneficial to know the drug allergy also, because a lot of times they really do not know. Okay, so this is the organizer whereby you can organize the medication. some of the tablets are very sweet, you know, like your neurobion is very sweet. Sometimes you put into normal box and what happened, the ants can come, you know. So you can buy this from the Japan home. I found this in the Japan home. I find it very good. So when I put the neurobion, the ants doesn't come anymore. Yeah. Surprise, sometimes the ants also do come, yeah. And then personal care is very important. Remember, you know, that you don't just take care of the external, but remember tooth decay and mouth problem can lead to what happened? Yeah, they will have malnutrition, eating difficulty, maybe because their mouth quite dirty, never really washed, brushed their teeth. And then it's very important to visit the dentist every 6 months. Okay, at least do all the scaling and whatever, because dental care is very important. Okay. And then next we'll go into the incontinence. If there's an incontinence, always consult the doctor. Okay, and then for female patients, especially when they are on diaper, it's always good to keep the perineum clean. Okay, and then if the elderly is wearing diaper, I mean, it's good to wean them off if possible and then pot them every 2 hours. Because once you wear diaper, what will happen? Sometimes you can have rashes and etc. A lot of problems will come in. Okay, personal care is important. So why do we not use soap on the skin? The normal kind of sabun. Why is that so? Yes, very dry. Because as we age, what happens is that our semen in our body will get lesser. So when you use soap, very dry, so they feel very itchy. So the best thing is get a moisturizer soap and then apply moisturizer after bathing. Okay? And then this is the last. Okay, for those elderly that are bedridden, very important, if they cannot turn themselves, usually we will ask them to get a pressure relief mattress. If they have no sore, we ask them to buy the 2-inch. Once, if they have a bed sore, because bed sore is classified under 4 stages, it's because of lack of supply to the buttock. So once they got a broken skin, they must buy the 4-inch pressure relief mattress. So there are many kinds. They have the 8-crate, they have the cell alternating. Yes?
Sleep on the floor.
Oh no, this one is put under the bed.
Sleep on the floor can solve the problem.
It doesn't solve the problem. Most...
The floor, you won't get it solved.
Because what happens is that sometimes for the caregiver to turn them on the floor, they will have backache. Because imagine how you're going to turn... The caregiver will have backache. So normally we will prefer them to put this pressure relief on the bed. And then they have the 8-crate. And then of course have to turn them every 2 hourly. Night time no need to turn because they're not the caregiver. Bye bye, I resign from my job. Yeah, because they also need rest. So only do in the daytime. Okay, so the pressure relief mattress doesn't matter which kind because research already shown it doesn't make any difference. Okay, and then sleep. It's very important. Some of them, they have sleep weight reversal. That means nighttime, they don't sleep, you know. Daytime, they sleep and sleep and sleep. So what we'll do is that normally we have to maintain a routine cycle. Just remember when they, okay, when they eat, don't carry the food to the bedroom. Because remember, eating is always at the kitchen or whatever. Okay, don't leave it in the bedroom. Bedroom is only for sleeping. They always try not to nap. Let's say if they sleep a lot in the night, that means don't nap in the daytime if possible. Okay, and then always, like I already mentioned, use bedroom only for sleeping. Avoid caffeine, alcohol, and tobacco, especially late in the night. Okay, and then reduce the noise at night. Make the room comfortable, make sure that you off the light. Okay, so what about yourself? You take care, right? You give yourself. There's some of that. I saw some of the caregivers, they come in, you know. Elderly, very nice powder, but they themselves so shag, you know. They come in. So remember yourself, you must take care. Okay, take one day at a time. Don't worry too much, okay? Okay, always tell them, don't worry. Worry will not get you anywhere, okay? And then if you need help, whether it be financial or what, remember even Tang Tok Seng, when the elderly comes to us with no money or even nobody take care, we will actually take over. No, usually we will call the social worker to come in. Okay, we will not deny them of any care. All right, and then always don't make everything perfect. You know, that means, wow, my house must be neat and tidy because there's no 100% care. Even as a nurse, I cannot make every patient 100% perfect. Cannot. Okay, and then always ask for help if you really need to. If you are very stressed, you know, verbalize. Don't take everything yourself, you know. And then if the elderly, if they have cancer or whatever, the most important thing is, for example, when my dad was diagnosed with cancer, that day when the doctor revealed to me, I tell you, it was like that day my father has died, I cried and I cried and I cried, But thank God, he gave me about 5 months, to prepare because my dad began to accept it. And by the grace of God, he I mean, he's with the Lord now. Yeah, so I was able to accept. Then during the funeral day, my mother asked me, why you didn't cry, huh? Then I told my mother, I said, mother, I already cried so much, you know. So on the funeral, because I got to arrange a lot of things, so I cannot be crying all the time, correct? And then if you have done your best, you shouldn't feel guilty. Yeah, because I know I have done my best as a caregiver, you know, as a daughter. And then always seek professional help, ma, when you need, lah. Okay? So these are some of the further reading. Actually, I have an interesting book, which I think is very good to have. If you want to buy, you have to buy it from my site. Okay, it's called Aging with Grace. It's a complete caregiver guide. It's very good. It's written by my geriatrician. It's from the beginning to the end of life. So this book is about $20+. If you're interested, you can... Maybe Jacqueline, I don't know. Do you know about this book? Okay, if you are interested, you can go over to the Center of Jerry Maxson over there. And then some of the books are Living with Healthy Lifestyles. This one not easy to get. I think when they attend the Chronic Disease Cell Management Workshop, I think just now somebody asked me, CDSMP, they do sell this book. And then Time to Help Your Parents, a practical guide. This one you need to get it from Kunikuya, I think the bookstore. Lah. Yeah, but the first book is a very highly recommended book. It's very good. But if you don't want to buy, there are other books lah, you can look out. Like the 36 Hours, written by Nancy Mays, is available in the Toa Payoh Library. So you can go to the library also. There's a lot of good books around. Just read it for your knowledge. Yeah, is there any question? If not, I shall end my... Usually why they have strong smell is because of the urine and the feces. Because when you pass urine, right, actually there is when you keep it too long in the pampers, there will be a smell. So very, very important thing is always keep the perineum clean. That means if they go toilet bath every day, they must wash it. Actually, people who use pampers or diaper, they are very prone to urinary tract infection, especially for female patients, because the urinary tract and the rectum is very close. That's why, if you can, you can pop them with a commode every 2 hourly. There's a commode, you can transfer them, then try to wean them off. Yeah, the hygiene very important. Because when they pass motion, imagine, it's very terrible, especially when they pass motion, they keep too long. Yeah, it's... Yeah, then they must drink enough water also.
Small drop,
they
drop into the pan, you don't know.
Yeah, the smell is there, yeah. So very important thing, the perineum care, you must really wash it. Yeah. So female, very high tension, and then they must drink enough water also, because a lot of us, we don't drink enough water, that's why we got, constipation, then we don't walk too much worse, all this problem, yeah. Okay, if there's no question, then...
I'll ask you, how to solve this? It's my mother. Well, my mother almost every day took taxi. They come back midnight, 3 o'clock, sometimes 2 o'clock. Now sometimes come back 10 o'clock. Then the taxi driver sometimes come back, follow up, take money. Move up, I come back.
Okay, but do you know where she go? Yeah. Maybe it's good that one of these days, if you can, you trail her along, because you do not know what they are doing. Yeah, but Chinatown don't close so late.
Somebody the officer call it. Somebody and I pass on the check.
Ah, okay. Maybe it's good to track lah.
I never shout at my mother, I never scold lah. I just tell my mother honestly, you can take taxi by all means. If I got a print money machine, if I can tell it's a print money, it's okay lah. Then one more thing, he like a ninja, he... Sometimes I resisted for him CC go outing. The CC ban him from going because he will disappear. The bus cannot find him. Then he go church also. He go church. Sometimes the church call your mother go missing again.
So sometimes this kind of condition, they may have dementia lor. So that's why you need to bring your mother to the geriatric medicine clinic. I mean, you can get a referral from the polyclinic or the CHAS GP clinic. We do accept also, and then do a cognitive assessment because they may have dementia. So, I got dementia, then in that case, they must have somebody to accompany them because you know why? Once they have dementia, sometimes they can even harm themselves. And then people can take advantage of them also.
My mother valued freedom. It will disappear. Like ninja. Okay. What my brother say, through a big comment, he say catch a Pokemon, easy to get degree. But now my mother, no, you disappeared. You were like ninja, you bring in.
Does anybody accompany her, like the maid or whatever?
My mother don't want me. Then we resided in for daycare center.
Okay, she want to go?
Sometime go, then sometime wake up. Then he go to the daycare center. Then once of them the ball while he run, then the stop chase up.
Okay, but it's true, I think she does have dementia. And then maybe your brother, you have to discuss, you know, what you're going to do for your mother. And then probably you have to get a domestic helper or what long. Yeah.
You can either you must I must
microchip him. Yeah? Microchip like the dog.
Okay. Yeah, but then we haven't come to that stage. Okay. Thanks for your question. But I think your mom does need medical help lah. Yeah, I think she's seeing any doctors?
Oh, which from my experience, I don't need the medicine better. Because sometimes the dementia. Eat
that
every day,
neck.
Now never eat,
better,
never
neck. But she does need a carer
lah. God protect us, nature thing, try to avoid processes. That nature thing can...
Yeah, it has a healing process, correct. Yeah.
The medicine slow down, I don't find it effective. It's a fact. Because what you say is too side effects.
But I think your mom do need, you need to discuss with your brother, and then you need to also tell your mom lah. You know what you're going to do for her, but I mean, if for me, I will probably get a domestic helper lor, because she may harm herself one of these days, or people can take advantage of her. You know, so yeah, because imagine when they have dementia, means their mentality not so good leh. Okay, I got to stop. Thank you for all the questions and for your attention. Yeah, thank you.